So here's some best practices. So I got two summary slides here. So you want to be transparent. Always disclose AI tools that you've used to ensure transparency and accountability. Verify the content. So carefully review all AI-generated content for accuracy, reliability, and alignment with your own research and ideas. Be sure to ensure proper attribution. If you use AI as an assistant with your research or paraphrasing or content generation, make sure that you have proper citations and acknowledgement of sources. So cite the papers properly and acknowledge all the sources that you used. You want to maintain academic integrity. So never use AI to fabricate data or plagiarize content. Always adhere to the standards of academic honesty and don't over rely on it. I think there's a tendency to over rely on AI. Just consider it a writing assistant or as a writing tool. Use it to support your work. Don't replace yourself with it. So make sure that your own unique ideas, your analysis and interpretation remain central in the content. Here's the caution on confidentiality. Remember, if you got to respect privacy and confidentiality. You don't know how the AI content was generated. It's still not clear to anyone. Maybe the AI developers, you have to be especially careful when handling sensitive or confidential information. You may not want to use AI, generative AI, if you have confidential information, because that information is not going to be confidential anymore. The AI is going to be trained on it. And this might hurt you. Maybe other researchers may get suggested this content when they're writing their own papers, and you might get scooped. So you want to incorporate human oversight. So always apply human review and judgment to AI generated content. Make sure it aligns with your intent and it meets academic standards. To ensure fairness, be mindful of the biases that may happen. They might be embedded in the tools or in the papers that they're trained on. You can take steps to mitigate them in your work. Use it responsibly, within ethical boundaries. And you don't want to generate misleading content. Again, all comes back to human oversight. And you can continuously learn and adapt. So stay updated on best practices of AI usage and the ethical guidelines. Consult your target journals for the best practices and follow their advices and make sure because in the end, you are responsible for your own work and the application of AI in your work. So here's some examples of ethical AI use. So generating ideas, research ideas. So this is in the very early stages of your research. I just got a message in the chat today from work. And there's actually a Google research. There's an AI assistant to help you generate ideas. I'm happy to share the link with you during the Q&A time. So this is very cutting edge in the latest technologies that are out there. And actually, some of them can be quite good at generating, helping you brainstorm. For example, narrowing the scope of your topic, and then the research process itself. Outlining, this is an excellent way to use AI. They're very good outliners and can help you, make sure you're not missing any sections in the structure of your paper. And also with creating an introduction with the literature review. These are great places for AI, but don't be very careful when you're using it for data interpretation and the results and then discussion. Make sure it's your data and your thoughts and your originality come through. And here, examples of unethical AI use. So over relying on it, like I just said, for writing entire sections, fabricating data, plagiarizing papers via AI generated content. So you don't want to just copy other papers with AI in hopes that you can get a paper in, past the editors. So don't use it for that. Or This is a pitfall. So misleading citations. So maybe your generated AI content doesn't attribute the original source. So you may be missing some citations, from having used AI tools. So be very careful.